الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله،
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، يقول سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد. My dear beloved respected brothers and sisters, I ask Allah Azza wa Jal who gathered us in this masjid to gather us يوم القيامة سيد المرسلين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. آمين يا رب العالمين. I want you to use your imagination for a few seconds. You were told, we are going to put you in a room 400 square feet, TV, internet, games, food, air conditioning, furniture, for 90 days. For 90 days, but you're not allowed to see anyone. How long will it take you to get bored? I asked this question over the weekend to a few teenagers. They answered a few hours. And when I asked brothers 20 and above, they said maybe a week. Now, remove the TV, remove the internet, remove the AC, remove the furniture, remove the food, shrink the room to 2x6, make it under the ground, turn off the light. How long will it take you to get bored? My brothers and sisters, the stay in the second scenario is not 90 days. Could be 90 years, 900 years, 10,000 years, a million years. Only Allah knows how long. And probably in our lifetime, we will never be offered the first option. But in 70 years or so, every single one person in this room will face the second option. So, Uthman radiallahu anhu, one time he stood by the grave and he started weeping. There was a sahaba around him. He said, why are you weeping? He said, because I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, the grave is the first stage of the hereafter. If someone is saved from its torment, everything after that will be easier. And if someone is not saved from its punishment, everything after that is worse. So the question is, how can we turn this small room, this small hole, into a piece of heaven and not a piece of the hellfire? Before we answer this question, many people doubt that there is punishment of the grave. Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he said, عذاب القبر حق ومن أنكره فهو ضال مضل. The punishment of the grave is حق, is true. And whomsoever denies it is a deviant and deviated others. And Allah Azza wa Jal told us in the Quran, وَحَاقَ بِآلِ فِرْعَوْنَ سُوءُ الْعَذَابِ النَّارُ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا غُدُوًا وَعَشِيًّا وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ أَدْخِلُوا آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ أَشَدَّ الْعَذَابِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us an evil torment will encompass the people of Pharaoh. And the fire, they are exposed to it day and night. And on the day of judgment, they will be sent to a severe punishment. So that means there is a punishment before the day of judgment. And the only place that this punishment will be is in the grave. And the dalil and the evidence from the sunnah is that our beloved messenger, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sought refuge in many places at many times from the punishment of the grave. How could he seek refuge with Allah from something that's not gonna happen? And the most dua that he made before taslim, before he finishes his salat, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adhabi jahannam wa min adhabi al-qabr wa min fitnati al-mahya wal-mamat wa min sharri fitnati al-masih al-dajjal. How can we be saved from the torment of the grave? Now we know that it's 100% authentic. My brothers and sisters, the way to be saved is to do something while we are still above the ground. Because when we are down there, it's too late. To be saved from the punishment of the grave, you need to be a muwahid. You need to have tawheed. You need to believe that there is only one ilah, one God that has no wife, no mother, no father, no child, an ilah that does not need anybody to help him. In order to be saved from the punishment of the grave, you have to have abundant salat, abundant fasting, abundant charity. You have to have good manners with the people around you, and specifically your parents. You have to tend to other people's needs. All these will save us from the punishment of the grave. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a long hadith, he said, فَإِنْ كَانَ مُؤْمِنًا كَانَتِ الصَّلَاةُ عِنْدَ رَأْسِهِ وَكَانَ الصِّيَامُ عَنْ يَمِينِهِ وَكَانَتِ الزَّكَاةُ عَنْ شِمَالِهِ وَكَانَ فِعْلُ الْخَيْرَاتِ مِنَ الصَّدَقَةِ وَالصِّلَةِ وَالْمَعْرُوفِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ إِلَى النَّاسِ عِنْدَ قَدَمَيْهِ أَوْ عِنْدَ رِجْلَيْهِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, when the person is in the grave and he was or she was a believer, when the punishment come from the head side, the salat would say, ما قبلي مدخل, you're not gonna come through here. And if the punishment come from the right side, the fasting will say, ما قبلي مدخل, you will not enter from here. And if the punishment come from the left side, the zakat, the charity will say, ما قبلي مدخل, you cannot come from here. And if it comes through the feet side, all the good deeds that he did above the ground would say, مَا قِبَلِ مَدْخَلْ, you cannot come from here. My brothers and sisters, in this dunya, when we buy a house, or when we build a house, we make sure that it's custom made in a way that make our dwelling in it comfortable, even though we all know that the stay in there is very, very short. How can we design our future home? أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. A topic that nobody ever mentions, every khatib is scared to talk about it, but it is the best way to be saved from the punishment of the grave, and that is to die a shaheed, mujahid fi sabilillah. Is to give your life fi sabilillah. We stop talking about jihad because out of fear. Many of our children do not know that it's one of the best ibadat you could ever perform because we are scared, as if we are telling them, let's go to jihad. We have to mention jihad, and we have to mention the virtues of jihad. One of the six gifts that the mujahid, the shaheed, is given is that he will be saved from the punishment of the grave. 100% he will be saved from the punishment of the grave. How can we be saved from the punishment? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, he said, Surah Al-Mulk, we used to call it Al-Mani'ah. On the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we used to call Surah Al-Mulk the one that prevents, because if you read it every single night, understand it, apply it, it will prevent from the punishment of the grave. Now, how can not only be saved, but turn that grave into na'im, into bliss, into joy? Lend me your hearts, my brothers and sisters, because this move to the new residence could literally be in a few minutes, if not tomorrow, or maybe earlier or later. To turn that 2x6 into a piece of paradise, all we have to do is to answer 3 questions. And from the mercy of Allah, from the greatness of Allah Azza wa Jal, He gave us the questions, He gave us the answers, and He gave us 50, 60, 80, 90 years to prepare. My brothers and sisters, what are these 3 questions that every single one of us will be asked? Man Rabbuk, the first question, who's your Lord? Ma Deenuk, what's your deen, what's your religion? And the third question, Ma Hadha Ar-Rajul Alladhi Bu'itha Feekum, what's the name of the man that was sent to you? If these questions were asked now, the youngest among us will answer them with his eyes or her eyes closed. But the answer on that date, the answer in that position, is not because of, strictly because of knowledge. ليست إجابة معرفة, not because you know the answer you will be able to answer. The answer to these questions, you do not need a diploma or a very high paying job. The answer to these questions will only be easy if you believed in the answer, if you lived the answer, if you believed in the answer and you lived the answer. قال الله عز وجل يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة. الله عز وجل will keep firm those who believe in him in this life, and he will keep them firm in the hereafter. What does it mean to believe in the answers? When we are asked, Man Rabbuk, who's your ilah? It is easy from now to say Allah. But at that moment, if you did not live by La ilaha illallah, if you did not live that Allah is only one, and He's the only one worthy of worship, and He's the only one that I ask and I beg, and I do not go to graves and I beg them for help, If you believe that Allah Azza wa Jal is the only one who knows the unseen, is the only one that is so merciful, so forgiving, so knowing, all expert, all wise, you will be able to say Allah. And you will only be able to answer and say, my religion is Islam, only if you lived Islam and you made it a way of life, not on the weekend, not when you are in the masjid, not only on a certain place, on a certain time. When you lived Islam, when you believed that Islam is the only deen accepted by Allah. إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهِ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. The only deen accepted and approved by Allah is Islam. I live Islam. I practice Islam. I eat according to Islam. I do business according to Islam. I dress like a Muslim. Only then, when we are asked, what's your deen? It will be easy to answer and say Islam. And the only way you will answer Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you above the ground believed that he is the final messenger, no messengers after him, the only one who came with the absolute truth, the one that received the revelation from Allah Azza wa Jal, the best man ever walked this earth, the man that I lived my life by imitating and duplicating his actions, only then I will be able to answer and say Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise, like the hadith continued, the person will be, it's in the hadith, the person who did not live by that, it was just a lip service. من ربك؟ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the person say, ما دينك؟ No, he doesn't know. He just said it because I was born in a Muslim family. That's it. One of the greatest blessings that Allah bestowed upon me and you, the greatest blessing is that He made us Muslims and He guided us and He made us believe in Him and only Him. My brothers and sisters, when we answer correctly, what happens? In many different ahadith, I will be narrating them all combined, but they are separate. When we answer correctly, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the angels who ask this the question would say, قَدْ كُنَّا نَعْلَمْ أَنَّكَ تَقُولُ ذَلِكَ. We knew that you're going to answer properly. We saw how you lived your life. We saw how you lived your life. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ أن صدق عبدي فافرشوه من الجنة وألبسوه من الجنة وافتحوا له بابا إلى الجنة فيأتيه من روحها وطيبها ويأتيه رجل حسن الوجه حسن الثياب طيب الروح فيقول أبشر بالذي يسرك هذا يومك الذي كنت توعد فيقول له من أنت فوجهك الوجه الذي يجيء بالخير فيقول أنا عملك الصالح. Your grave will be illuminated. When we answer the proper answer, your grave will be illuminated. It will expand as far as your eyes can see. It will be furnished from Jannah. And it will have the fragrance of Jannah. And you will be dressed from clothes of Jannah. And a handsome person will accompany you in that grave. And the best of the best thing at all is that you will have a Jannah view until you are resurrected. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أحدكم إذا مات عرض عليه مقعده بالغداة والعشي إن كان من أهل الجنة فمن أهل الجنة. حديث البخاري and Muslim. When a person from the people of Jannah die, she will be shown her place in Jannah day and night while they are in the grave. Not an ocean view, not a garden view, a Jannah view, as long as you are staying in the qabr. My brothers and sisters, we come to Jum'ah, we leave Jum'ah, MashaAllah, Shaykh, beautiful khutbah. Please do not tell me that. I'm not here talking and putting my heart out so you can tell me it's a beautiful khutbah. I want me and you to do something. When our brother 3 weeks ago, Sheikh Abdullah Kamel, 38 years old, younger than many of us, slept and never woke up. And every single one in the crowd have a story about someone they knew that disappeared all of a sudden. Please, I beg you, answer this question. What makes me and you think that we are not next? Who fooled me? Who gave me the guarantee that you are still young, you are still strong, you are still healthy, you are still wealthy, you still have a very long time, enjoy? It is the shaitan, it is the devil. But we all know, if I say, who can dare raise his hand if he can guarantee me he will be here at Fajr? Guaranteed, nobody will, because everybody knows that tonight could be our last night. And we will be going to the place we discussed. And now, and only now, I can make that place a piece of Jannah or a piece of the hellfire. It's our decision. It's our decision. You have been warned. You have been warned. لا دار للمرء يسكنها إلا التي كان قبل الموت يبنيها فإن بناها بخير فطاب مسكنه وإن بناها بشر فخاب بانيها. It's a poem that is said that Ali radiallahu anhu narrated. It says, there's no house for the individual to live in after death except the one he was building before death. If he built it with goodness, pleasing his dwelling will become. And if he built it with evil, how disappointed the builder will be. Allahumma thabbitna inda su'al. اللهم ثبتنا عند السؤال. I want you to please introduce this new dua to your life, to your dua bank. اللهم ثبتني عند السؤال. يا الله, keep me steadfast when I'm being questioned. Maybe there will be nobody around us to make dua. Inshallah, there will be a lot of people. But to be on the safe side, I'm going to make this dua for myself. اللهم ثبتنا عند السؤال. اللهم ثبتنا عند السؤال. اللهم أحسن خاتمتنا يا رب العالمين. يا الله, make us steadfast when we are being questioned. يا الله, make our last deeds our best deeds and our last words لا إله إلا الله. يا الله, grant our parents the highest place in Jannah. يا الله, forgive their sins. يا الله, يا كريم, يا رب العالمين, protect our children. يا الله, يا الله, protect our children. يا الله, make them the coolness of our eyes. يا الله, protect our spouses. يا رب العالمين. يا الله, make the hijab beloved to our women. يا رب العالمين. يا كريم, يا أرحم الراحمين, اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم انصر إخواننا في السودان. اللهم انصر إخواننا في السودان. اللهم أنزل في السودان الثبات والأمان. اللهم يا رب العالمين, انصر إخواننا في غزة وانصر إخواننا يا رب العالمين المجاهدين في كل مكان. اللهم أغث إخواننا المسلمين في كل مكان. وصلى الله الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وقوموا إلى صلاتكم. Inshallah, after the salat, just remain seated for a minute or two. One of our to-be brothers is going to take his shahada, inshallah. Please move forward and fill up the main hall. Look down, close the gaps, fill up the spaces. Heels on the line.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
اعتدلوا الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله. أريك أريك first person who decided to be saved from the punishment of the grave. Inshallah. All right. Eric, alhamdulillah, he is very interested in Islam. He has checked other faith and he only felt comfortable when he studied and knew about Islam. And alhamdulillah, Allah guided him to be here with us and to give us the honor to give you the shahada. Ready?
Yes, sir.
Closer. Ashhadu.
Ashhadu.
Allah.
Allah.
Ilaha.
Ilaha.
إلا
الله
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 و
وأشهد أشهد
أن
أن
محمدا
محمدا
رسول
رسول
الله
الله.
I bear witness
I bear witness
that
that
there is none worthy of worship
there is none worthy of worship
except Allah
except Allah.
And I bear witness
and I bear witness
that Muhammad
that Muhammad
peace be upon him
peace be upon him
is his final messenger
is his final messenger.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. As you can see, alhamdulillah, he's half Muslim already. with the shahada he completed his salam. Alhamdulillah. Look, you know, this is very this is Moroccan style. So if somebody called you now Moroccan, let it go, yani. Okay, inshallah. So alhamdulillah, Rabbi, I mean, you could come and congratulate. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless Eric and to keep him steadfast and make him a reason for others to become Muslims. Jazakumullah khair.